We interrupt this footage of a monkey washing a kitty cat to bring you the following special program.
Hey, have you noticed that you never seem to get laid much on Thanksgiving? I think it's because all the coats are on the bed. That's my job, thinking up goofy shit. Coming around every now and then, letting you know what it is. Or reminding you of things you already knew, but forgot to laugh at the first time.
If I told you he was considered alongside Charlie Chaplin and Buster Keaton as one of the most influential film comedians of the silent era, you'd probably think to yourself, other than Keaton and Chaplin, who else is there? If I said his films frequently contain thrill sequences of extended chase scenes in daredevil physical feats, you might say, wait a minute, wasn't that Buster Keaton? And to some degree, Chaplin as well? Well, you wouldn't be wrong. Then if I said, he made nearly 200 comedy films between 1914 and 1947, and unlike Keaton and Chaplin, he was successful in both silent and talkies. You might be starting to conjure up an image in your head. But if I then showed you a picture of him hanging from the hands of a clock high above the street in 1923, you would definitely recognize the face due to the fact that it is considered to be one of the most enduring images in all of cinema. But I guarantee you, unless you're a film nerd like myself, you probably still wouldn't be coming up with a name. Even I wasn't fully educated about this performer before doing this series, but I know damn well that he was funny and talented, and I knew that I liked him even before studying him more. I also felt that his facial expression stood out above the rest, that he was definitely ahead of his time. There's a lot more depth in his comedy. I know now that he is the third of the three greatest silent comedians of all time. He is Harold Lloyd. Harold Clayton Lloyd was an American actor, comedian, and stunt performer who appeared in many silent comedy films. Although Lloyd's individual films were not as commercially successful as Chaplin's on an average, he was far more prolific than Chaplin ever was and made many more movies and much more money overall. He released 12 feature films in the 1920s, while Chaplin released just four. He is the first comedian on our list to represent a more everyday type man, an average man, a guy you can emotionally identify with, not only because his films are more situational than physical, depicting everyday trials and tribulations that we all deal with, only handling them in a very over-the-top, grandioso cinematic way. But also, he's the first of the film comedians to communicate things with his eyes better. Buster Keaton only communicated one emotion with his deadpan face, static, throughout his entire career, throughout all his pictures. And Chaplin, while way more animated than Buster, still only had about five or six emotions that he communicated. And he communicated them through his whole body. Whereas Harold Lloyd had a wide range of facial expressions to communicate emotions and is able to communicate exactly what he's feeling instantly and immediately through just a look at the camera. Now, Harold Lloyd's character wasn't a tough guy. He wasn't a fighter. The Tramp, Buster Keaton's character, they were more fighters. They would persevere. Harold Lloyd's character was the type that would get all up in his feelings. You know, the kind of motherfucker would be feeling a certain type of way and not be able to hide it. But that's what made him more real. No, Harold Lloyd wasn't a fighter. Harold Lloyd was a lover. I lie awake, I've gone to ground, I'm watching porn, in my hotel dressing gown, and now I dream of you, but I still believe. Clayton Lloyd was born on April 20th, 1893, in Burchard, Nebraska. In 1910, after his father had several business ventures fail, Lloyd's parents divorced and his father moved with his son to San Diego, California. Lloyd had acted in theater since a child, but in California began acting in one-reel film comedies around 1912. Lloyd worked with Thomas Edison's Motion Picture Company, and his first role was a small part as a Indian in the production of Old Monk's Tale. At the age of 20, Lloyd moved to Los Angeles and took up roles in several Keystone comedies. He was also hired by the Universal Studios as an extra and soon became friends with an aspiring filmmaker, Hal Roach, who becomes very important next month in the history of comedy. Lloyd began collaborating with Roach, who had formed his own studio in 1913. Roach and Lloyd created Lonesome Luke, similar to and playing off the success of Charlie Chaplin's Tramp character. By 1918, Lloyd and Roach had begun to develop this character way beyond an imitation of his contemporaries. Harold Lloyd would move away from tragic comic personas and portray an everyman with an unwavering confidence and optimism. The persona that Lloyd referred to and was creating at this time was called his glass character, often named Harold in the silent films. Beginning in 1921, Roach and Lloyd moved away from shorts to full feature-length comedies. These included the acclaimed Grandma's Boy, Girl Shy, The Freshman, The Kid Brother, Speedy, and Welcome Danger. But the film that he's most known for, the film that cemented Lloyd's stardom, and the oldest film on the American Film Institute list of 100 most thrilling movies, was Safety Last. Safety Last is the movie that has Harold Lloyd hanging off what would appear to be a clock face by the minute hand up above a bustling urban city.
At the sound of tone, the time will be 12 a.m.
In the intro, cue up the searchlight, promise to the center stage.
I grab the first mic,
projecting the voice with this mic that I'm cuffing. You ain't my knuckle, sucker, I'm snuffing. The word of the third stands true, so no panicking.
Man versus man,
you freeze up like a mannequin. Petrol, you let go the wax for the new jacks to dwell upon. You stepping on the trigger as the tune smacks.
Square in the butt,
Pete gave me the cue, so I'ma put up a shut up until my jam is through. But for now, I wanna freak him, so I'll embark to spark and mission posse the way past dark.
Don't park, there's no standing.
Or I'll play the 5-0. You don't stop moving until the search says so to keep the tribe open. Shooting out to play him, 3 the hard way and keep you stepping to the AM.
In 1924, Harold Lloyd formed his own independent film company, the Harold Lloyd Film Corporation, with his films distributed by Pathé and later Paramount, 20th Century Fox. Lloyd was a founding member of the Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences. Lloyd studied colors in microscopy and was very involved with photography, including 3D photography and color film experiments. He became known for his nude photographs of models, such as Betty Page and stripper Dixie Evans, for a number of men's magazines. He also took photos of Marilyn Monroe lounging by his pool in a bathing suit, which were published after her death. In 2004, his granddaughter, Suzanne, produced a book of selections from his photographs titled Harold Lloyd's Hollywood Nudes in 3D. Marilyn Monroe, Betty Page, Zazu Pitts, and Thelma Todd and Mary Pickford, and this guy was a pimp. He got more bumper than a body shop.